So before we get to Marquette's talk, we just have a little bit of housekeeping to go through. So first off, if you don't know, our mission statement, Blender Collective is a community of software engineers to basically help grow our skills, share knowledge, and help each other progress throughout our careers. And our sponsors are, our annual sponsors is this meetup, which is Excella and Endgame. Both of them are based in Arlington, and they are looking for full-stack developers. With Excella, most are looking for just public trust clearance. And then Endgame, it's a API endpoint security company, and they recently got acquired, but they're still actively looking for developers. So, and our space is, of course, provided by Aptoro. And today, we're here to listen to the amazing Marquette talk about how you can leverage social media, YouTube, and blogs to land a job. And before we get started on that, we just want to introduce our BCC merch. We are going to be starting off by selling enamel pins. They will be $5, and we will be setting up order forms, and we'll be posting this all in the meetup group and everything like that, as well as tweeting it out in our Slack group. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us or email our Gmail.
Or ask in Slack
as well. And some upcoming events, next month, July 16th, we have a hack night at Pivotal Labs, and it'll be a good time for you to come with your favorite project, hang out, talk, and everything like that. It's always a good time to just kind of be able to code and hack amongst other black folks, you know? And yeah, that's it. Now I'm gonna pass it over to Mark Lenz.
So before I get started into the whole how to use social media to land a job, I'm gonna give a little bit of my background just so you guys can see where I came from to get into that and to become a software engineer, just in case you're kind of in a similar space or trying to navigate getting into tech without a degree or something like that. And so when I was young, when I was 18, getting out of high school, I planned on going to art school, studying graphic design and animation. The art school wanted a lot of money up front, so I wasn't able to afford it. And I went to a community college. I hated the college, ended up dropping out. I worked full-time at Famous Days, serving tables and people with and stuff like that. And at the time, it was cool. It was, I guess, pretty good money for a 19, 20-year-old kid. But I did realize it wasn't what I wanted to do. I wanted to work with computers. I was still doing graphic design a little bit, but I needed somewhere to go. So I ended up going to the school called Europe. What Europe essentially is a nonprofit organization that helps young adults between the ages of 18 and 25 get into tech. You do about 6 months of taking college courses and career development, and then you have technical training, and then 6 months at an internship. Hopefully you get hired, but if not, you gained a lot of skills, you have a better resume, and you have some college courses under your belt, so you can either transition into working full-time or college. So during my time there, I got an internship at a cybersecurity company, and I began my career as a cyber intelligence analyst. I've been a cyber intelligence analyst for about 8 years before I finally transitioned into web development. Probably spent about 2 or 3 years before that saying, yes, I want to be a developer and I want to get there. So at an early age, I knew I liked the idea of coding. I wanted to make video games for a living. And I used to write HTML and CSS on the paper on the floor in my kind of living room. Eventually, I thought it was too hard, too much math. I wasn't going to be able to do it. There was nobody I could turn to and say, hey, how did you get into coding? How did you get into tech? Because nobody in my family is into tech. So it's just me trying to figure it out. No programs at school. So I got a little older and thought about it in college, saw those math classes, and said, nah. So then a friend of mine, he got into coding. I want to say he had more experience at the time than I had, and he decided to jump in, did a job, became a developer, got a job as a developer. Okay, he can do it, smart, but just as smart. So then I ended up finding like Code Academy one day, just in my room on the computer, chilling, whatever. And I was like, what's this? Oh, this is like teaching me how to code. So I haven't tried out, and I started doing things, and it was some things that I remember from being a kid. And I was like, okay, cool, I can do this. So at this point, I ended up finding other websites, like CodeTool, C Code Academy, and I had to spend more and more time coding. One day, I was going out on a Friday night. I think I got like a flat tire or something, kind of just going the whole night. Went home, and I was like, well, let me do some more coding stuff. And that's the first time I made my own like personal resume site, and I was really excited about it. I was like, I can really do this. I mean, even if I don't ever get into JavaScript thing, maybe I can make some basic websites for people and make some money on the side or something. But I really felt like I could be a developer at that point, and was really, really excited. Then I decided I was spending too much time coding when I wasn't like doing anything else. Any free time I was coding, girlfriend's like, hey, Dennis, I didn't like it. Yeah, I'm coding right now. So that got a new problem. Like, I was just spending too much time doing it, so I decided to go to a boot camp full time. While on full stack development, more HTML, CSS, learn JavaScript, learn Node, learn React, the front end, databases, like the whole nine. I met some good friends there, spent a lot of hours coding and learning, going over things over and over and not getting much sleep, but I made it through. And then after the boot camp, and I'm sorry, I forgot to mention, I have like emojis because I couldn't think of like what pictures to put on the slides. Like I need something, so I have to do emojis. So after the boot camp, I did everything they tell you that you should do to get a job. I applied to a lot of places. I went on LinkedIn and found people at the places, and like, hey, you know, introduce myself, hope that they would pass me to the next person, to an actual person, and not just have me in the system. Went to meetups, talked to people, shook hands, kissed babies, like the whole nine. I had a lot of interviews, actually. I had a lot of classmates that were having trouble getting interviews, and there was a good amount also getting interviews, but it seemed like I was getting a ton compared to everybody else. Sometimes it was just kind of phone interview, see, like, you know, get to know you a little bit, see if you meet the qualifications. I was getting through a lot of those and going on second and third interviews. I think I had one job, I went on four interviews. And it always ended up like, we're going to go with somebody else had more experience, things of that nature. So I was getting a little frustrated, getting depressed, like a lot of times. I graduated, I think it was a year before I actually found a job as an engineer, about 6 months before I found a job. Which, sorry, I forgot about this part. No, you can go through.
Right.
So, during my time, this was kind of my thinking too. Like I said, I was depressed, I was upset, I felt like I just went through a lot of time and money. Like, I'm trying to do better for my family, and I'm just like setting this back with like this debt that I've been incurring, and like, oh. And this song like meant a lot to me and really hit me hard, specifically like this part of the song, the whole song, this part, and I kind of like felt exactly what Nixon was saying. Like, not saying I'm a genius or anything, but he's smart, but like I just felt like I was trapped, was nothing I could do, and I felt like I could really do it. I could code, I could build stuff, I can, you know, change the world. Like, I felt like I was gonna be able to do something as a developer, I wanted to like better the world as a developer. And I'm like, I'm dedicated to this, I'm not getting an opportunity, like it's not gonna happen. Like, maybe I should figure something else out. And then I looked it up. I finally got a job. I was a TA at Joel Clarkson University. I worked online. I helped teach other people to code, and hopefully they could also achieve their dream of becoming a developer. So I did that online 3 days a week, part-time. So I was working here like Monday, Wednesday, and Saturday. I was working also still in my cybersecurity job. I was able to keep that. So I'm juggling these jobs. I had a pretty good experience working at Bootcamp. And while I was there, I really realized I like teaching. And I thought back to my time at Bootcamp and spent a lot of time with other people trying to figure this stuff out. And I was pretty good at my Bootcamp. I wasn't like some of these people that were like just geniuses, like why you can't teach it. But I was pretty good, so I ended up taking time and explaining things to other people. And by doing that, it reinforced my knowledge. And teaching at GW also did the same thing. So I made, I think, one or two YouTube videos for my class for some concepts they were having trouble with. And you know, you only have so much time. And I'm like, hey, I'll make a YouTube video and I'll send out the link. And they liked it. And I was like, God, I should do this for real. I've been thinking about it before. I should stop playing and actually do it. So then I said, okay, cool. I'm gonna make a YouTube channel. I'm gonna do all the marketing stuff I need to do on social media. I'm going to get the following. And I'm going to, either I'm going to have somebody see me doing this, feel like I'm going to hire this guy, or I'm going to figure out a business plan myself. And I'm going to teach. Maybe I can be the next Lost Boss. If you don't know who Lost Boss is, he's a developer that sells courses online. He also like the conferences and talks and stuff. And I actually bought one of his classes. He has really good JavaScript and React classes, front and back end. And he had a class come up recently, and he sold like 20,000 classes for like 40 to 80 or something crazy. I'm like, I'm gonna figure something out. Like either way, I can't just be sitting here and upset that I'm not doing a job. So at the time, I had about 45 Twitter followers, and I had friends and family to subscribe to my YouTube channel that had no content, but something was coming soon. So I started with like basically nothing. I'm not a big social media guy. I don't really look to get followers and stuff like before in the past. Like I really didn't care. It was just and then about 2 months later, I actually ended up getting over 1,000 followers on Twitter, about 270 followers on YouTube, over 180 hours on Lifetime. And people really seemed to be enjoying my content, and I was having people like in my mentions asking for videos or feedback on the podcast, people, just a lot of engagement with people. And at the same time, I'm getting a lot of people coming to me saying, hey, so that you're not full-time employed anywhere. My job's hired. And then I would have other people, you know, like, hey, I'm a manager at such company. Why don't you give me a, you know, send me an email, let's set something up, someone calendar, let's have an interview. And so before, I'm getting a lot of recruiters saying, hey, I have a job, you know, you need 5+ years of JavaScript experience, some Java and Backbone, Ember, all this stuff I don't even understand what it is. Like, we want this, are we a good fit, you know, give me a call. I'm getting a lot of those emails. I'm getting a lot of emails from people that like really weren't good leads. So I was getting stuff and I'm putting resumes out. I don't know if people are seeing it. I'm doing interviews with people and they disappear and come back a month later like, hey, something came up and did you still want the job? But now I'm getting actual developers, people that work at the company, and I'm getting managers saying, hey, let's set something up, let's do an interview. And I felt like I was really getting traction, and the interview process was going very well at the time, and I felt like I was close to securing a job. And then I got a train job working at Elevate before, great company. I can talk on and on about it, but I'll just skip to the part about how this happened. It happened because of social media. I sent out a tweet promoting a video, saying, hey, new video on whatever, because I'll check it out. He looked at it, he liked the video. he liked the idea that as a junior developer, all we had a mindset to help other people and help teach people how to code and become developers and achieve their dream. And he like that's a key thing with developer, period. And he's like, that's what he did as a senior developer. He helps other people become better developers so they can help the next person and we can all build great software together. And he really liked that. He checked out my website, which looked better than it does now then. And he was like, hey, like, this guy looks like he knows what he's talking. He's saying the right thing. His website looks good. He goes, he emails me, he sets something up, we have a talk, and go through the interview process. I got hired. I had multiple offers on the table at this time, around this time. So I got an offer from a company, 3 days before my last interview there. I had an offer from GW to come on and work full time with them. And I had an offer from another company as well for a different role that was technical. It wasn't as much programming as I would like, but it was kind of whatever. So I'm feeling great. And the new job that I work at has the values of reinvesting each other, we're reliable, and our work benefits our world. And the guy that found me is Mr. Star. Not this guy, but his less famous cousin here, Dan. And I told him I was gonna like videotape this and like make this joke, so I definitely had to throw it in there. So next one. This title was saying, is social networking better than or equal to traditional networking and the sense of the value that you get out of it? Is that true or is that false? And we'll kind of maybe get to answer that at the end. But I will say that my social networking got me better leads. I had more to show from it. I was having better interviews. I was getting better traction. And I have a YouTube channel with like 30 videos to show people. And I have, you know, people can see like, oh, you know, he's talking about, you know, they can vet me before they even get to the interview process, which actually happened at my job. Like, everybody in the office, when I started, like, knew, like, hey, the guy with the YouTube channel, right? You know, I heard about you. Like, you killed it at the interview. Everybody said great things. They were already looking at this stuff before I got there. And I got that at other interviews, too. Like, yeah, we checked out your channel. You know, I liked your latest video or so-and-so and such-and-such. So these people already have it in mind. Like, he understands these things. They can see me saying, you know, other actions on social media. Like, hey, I saw you on Twitter. You said, like, you're uncomfortable with something. You didn't know how it worked, but somebody asked to make a video, so you just figured it out and made a video about it. Like, that's, we like that. We like that you're showing that you're going quickly. And it just gives you, instead of just a resume and a piece of paper, it gives you more to show that hiring manager. And so, if you're just sending an email out to somebody or a resume out, they might not take the time to look at that content, but if somebody is saying, like, hey, I found this guy, he's a good developer, he has a good YouTube channel. Like, if somebody comes to you and says that to you, you're more likely to check it out than if you just see it on the resume. You're like, oh, they have a YouTube channel, cool. But with me having people who actually say, this is a guy that we should hire, I was getting more of that kind of interaction. I was talking about coding confidently. I learned a lot of new things. I refined old things that I worked on. I was going over things, like reiterating things. I was reading a lot of code, reading a lot of blogs. I was comfortable in fields of doing it, like social media, period, and YouTube, like just looking for me. And I got a really strong sense of fundamentals in programming because I did a lot of videos for like early developers as well. And getting into like deeper things like higher order functions, you really have to understand like, well, you know, I know what a for loop is, but now I have to understand like, okay, a for loop is just a way of doing iteration, and I'm doing the same thing with math or for each, and this is how it's going over. And I'm just getting a deeper understanding of just core JavaScript. Okay, so also some people think social media is like because they don't like going and doing things in person, so they don't have to. They can talk to more people at once, like I'm talking to about 15 of you right now, but tweet something and thousands of people will see it, and you have a big impact. You can, you know, you just, you can see more. They think it's fun and they can get a lot bigger. So this is what I'm gonna get into, why you should use social media and encourage you to do these kind of things. So I had, you know, some other people was like, hey, you know, I see you like doing all these videos now, and I see you like on Twitter a lot, and like I think that's really cool, and I heard you recently started a job. Like, I wish I thought to do that, and I'm like, do it. Stop leaving people like, well, I don't want to kind of like step on your toes. I'm like, no, it's enough internet and YouTube for all of us out here. I know personally, if I go to read up on something, I'll look at a blog, read it, like, all right, that kind of makes sense. But then I'll read another blog post and another on the same topic and just make sure everybody's saying the same thing. Like, this one guy isn't just making stuff up. And that's kind of how I consume stuff, and it's the same with the videos. I'll watch a bunch of videos on the same thing, really let it sink in, and I'm like, no, just do it. And all of the pluses that I said you're gonna get, you're gonna really start to understand stuff more, you're gonna build confidence, you're gonna have more content to show, you're gonna have a better like portfolio to show outside of just your resume and saying that you have these skills and working with things. And people are gonna see your progress. There's so many things you can do if you're just out there making content. And it doesn't have to just be YouTube videos. You might not want to be on the camera. You might not want to talk on the mic. You can start a blog. You might be a good writer, so you might want to start a blog and talk about, like, hey, I worked on this today. And it can be any kind of style. So definitely put your own twist into things, into your videos, into your writing. You know, like, on my videos, people would be, like, they like. I had a couple people give me feedback. Like, every video I start with, like, hey, what's up, guys? This is what. And they're like, that's you. Like, that's, yeah. And just the way I talk in my videos, like, I'm just being me. Which is also something you should do in whatever you're doing. Just be you, because whatever companies out there looking for you, you want to give them your personality, but you want to make sure, not too much personality, but enough to they get to know you a little bit, the genuine sense of you, because it's going to be horrible if you go to a company and you're not a fit. They don't really like you, you guys don't gel, you don't mess at all. They're like, oh, we didn't mean to hire you, you know? You wanna make sure that they know who you are before you get in there, and that they're fine with that. Because you don't wanna go somewhere and just be like, no, I hate you. So create content that you find fun, and would like to watch. I think that's what it is. Just be you in everything that you're doing. And you can write your blog posts about anything. So, literally, like, anything tech-related, just go for it. Don't think, like, oh, I write about that, but everybody knows what Photo is. Everybody understands what this is. Why would I write a blog on VAR? Somebody out there doesn't know what VAR equal means. They don't know what it's like to assign a variable, anything. And then you could go into the article, and they would be like, oh, so a variable just quotes something. And they're like, oh, and there's different data types in JavaScript. You know, there's booleans, there's strings, there's integers. Somebody doesn't know that out there, they'll see your blog post and you're gonna help them grow. And they're gonna come back and look at more of your content. So write about anything and everything, just go out there. Sorry. Don't be afraid to learn anything. I mentioned that before. I would not know stuff, and I would go look it up, study, go for it, and then I would record a video and teach it. So if you don't know something, if you're scared to learn it, just go after it. There's plenty of things in my boot camp. Like I said, higher functions were really confusing. I'm really using them. There was using the spread operator. I was like, what is the spread operator? A couple of things that I just didn't know. I was scared to go learn it. It didn't make sense when I looked it up one time. I'm like, yeah, whatever. So don't be afraid to look into something and just figure it out. Use everything that you, use just to learn what you like and what you don't like. So you might find out I'm interested in the topic, go research, go build it. Be like, I don't like that, it wasn't fun. You could go and start working on things and realize, like, hey, this is actually something I really like. I found that with some of my boss courses, I found out I actually liked writing CSS and JavaScript. And I was like, oh, this is really cool. I really like how this is organized, the way I was doing it before I didn't like. And so now I'm finding out that I like those things. And you might go out there and discover you're working on something or helping somebody learn something, like, hey, I tried Chess so don't be afraid to do that. And there's the same, like, fail up. Like, if you don't get something, if you have trouble with something, if you just flat out fail, just take that as a lesson and just make the next thing you do better from us. And here, just kind of summarizing everything. So get on Twitter and Instagram and promote your talent to meet people. So when you're on Twitter and when you're on Instagram, you can have fun and interact with people and just talk. But you want to make sure that you're definitely promoting your stuff, promoting your video, promoting your blogs. Get on every day and say, hey, check out my latest blog post, check out my latest video. Try to keep it fun. I would do like a tweet in the morning, like, hey, new video out on blah, blah, blah. And so people are seeing that, but I'll also make sure that in the evening, I tweet it out again so that people in the evening getting off work doing whatever they're doing are also seeing it. But if somebody's like seeing both, I'm like, I don't like it going, like tweeting the same thing over and over. So I would find a different way to say it. So the first time I might be like, hey, new video, check it out. Second time, I might pose like a coding problem in my tweet, like a short snippet, and be like, does this make sense to you? If not, check out my new video. And I actually got feedback from people that said they really like the fact that I would do like interesting like type of problems inside of my tweets, because they were like, I might not have watched the video if you just said it's on a higher order function, but when you had that code problem in it, I couldn't help but like read the code. And I kind of understood it, or I didn't understand it, but it wasn't intimidating. It drew me in. So try to be creative with the way that you market your content as well, but just make sure that you're always promoting it. Don't be like overly annoying with it, but you should be out there promoting yourself at least 3 or 4 days a week, promoting what you have out there. And make sure that while you're also out there, promote your talent with like Twitter talks. So there's a community chat every Monday or Tuesday. Check out Code on Twitter, and they should have the name somewhere on their Twitter. But I would do that like every Monday and Tuesday. They ask a series of questions, you retweet it, you put your answer. And people are seeing that. There's a lot of eyes on that chat at the time because people are searching the hashtag and looking at it. And at the end of that, she'll be like, hey, there's a woman named Sharon that, or Sharon, that runs the company. And at the end, she'll be like, do you have anything to promote? Any wins, any accomplishments for the week? And you can say, hey, I got a new video on such and such. I got a new blog post on this and that. And a lot of people are searching and looking at that hashtag. And then you have a lot of eyes that's looking into your content that otherwise wouldn't have been. I swear I had a slide about data in here. I'm sorry. Data in here, but I don't think I touched on that. Use the data that you get from social media to your advantage. I know if you saw the blog, there's somewhere where you can see how many people are coming and reading your blogs, how long they're reading it, clicks, all of that type of Google Analytics. Definitely look at that and see what people are interested in. Where are people watching most of your content? What videos are they helping people the most? What blog posts are they getting the most traction? Like, pay attention to that. So don't get caught up in likes and retweets and stuff, but make sure you're paying attention enough where you're seeing like people are really liking this, or maybe they're not liking this. Don't get caught up on like, oh, well, I had more likes with my last video than the last one. That's not necessarily what matters. But if you see that you put a video out and nobody liked it, and nobody, maybe people aren't interested in that topic. And if you put one out and a lot of people are watching, maybe you should put more content out on that topic, because it's likely those people are really interested in it, want to learn more about it. But and also just get you more people in so you can help more people learn and also show your content to more people and have more eyes looking at your content and saying, oh, I like this. I like this man. I like this woman. I want to bring them in and bring them on my team. Sorry. There's also other things you can do, such as start a blog or start a podcast. Like I said, definitely don't stress about numbers. And also just be you in your content, like I mentioned earlier. Just give them some personality. Don't go out and like do too much. Like don't go be super ratchet online. But just give them some personality. And if somebody says like, I don't like this about you, or I don't like that about you, just keep being you. Like there were so many other people like, you know, you probably get a job if you just cut your hair. And I'm like, I don't want to work at a place that doesn't like you if I'm like a regular haircut. Like if that intimidates you about this, then I'm not gonna work with you. I want to work somewhere where I can feel comfortable and where I can enjoy people when they feel comfortable around me. definitely be you, and don't stress about numbers. Do set goals. I set boost goals around how many viewers I, not viewers, how many subscribers I would want, or how many, you know, followers I think I should build, how many videos I should make, and I set these goals, and then like I would just crush all of them. I mainly had goals on like subscribers and stuff like that, and I'm like, yeah, if I get like 100 followers and 50 subs by the end of the year, I'm like, I'll be at a good spot where like I'm seeing my stuff, and then I had like 1,000 followers, and I'm like, alright, well, but like I said, I didn't care. It wasn't about the numbers, it was just more so about, for me, spreading my video to as many people as possible, and also getting more eyes on my content so that I could be in a good position to start my business or have somebody hire me. And so I was going to say that was also just kind of the plan. It's like if this doesn't work, if this doesn't get me people, then it's going to help me make my own business. I'm sorry, if this doesn't get somebody to hire me, it's going to help me start my business. And other recommendations that I have for helping you while you're on a job search and while you're, you know, building your content and trying to get a job is find passion projects to work on. Find something that you really, really want to build and do it. Just go for it and see where you go with it. And if you see something that's open source, really like what they're building, and go for it. Start building it. Talk to some type of organizer on the project. Say, hey, you know, new into development. I really want to work with you guys. Do you have any beginner-friendly issues or tickets that I can work on? And just find something you're passionate about, because it'll definitely help you keep going. I know how hard it is to keep programming when you feel like you're not getting anywhere with it. So do that. Finish your projects. Find out what you're interested in. Try new things. Like I said, don't be afraid. Just do it. There was also a lot of music that I listened to, and these three songs kind of helped the most. Jay-Z had a line in Nice where he talks about what would you do if you knew you couldn't fail, and he was like, he had no fear of anything, he does everything well. And I really appreciated that, because I was like, yeah, what if I couldn't fail? What would I do? What would I do? What would I start doing? And I was like, well, if I had already started a YouTube channel by then, but like, I was like, I'm glad I did it. Like, I did it like I wasn't going to fail, and I didn't, and he did great. And I started working on an app that I'm building, and I feel like it's going to really have a great impact on people. And like, I'm not afraid of like somebody else having a superior product, because other people also have this thing. I've done my research, but I'm like, I have to find a way to stand out. If I go and get paper towels, there's 20 different brands of paper towels, and people are buying all 20 brands, so somebody's going to like my app. Dedication, which I already went over. Do code challenges. This is also great content to put out as YouTube videos or blogs. If you haven't heard of Code Ninja, definitely check out Code Ninja. Google Kata's Code Ninja. I'm definitely like losing the name right now. But it's a website where you have code challenges you can do, and it's just some type of like problem. And it's like, you need to, like a simple one, it's like, take two variables and return a value for the two variables. I think that's like the unlock, just say you know the language. And so you just write a variable, like a function, and it's gonna take in X and Y, and you're gonna return X plus Y, and that passes the counter. It gets a lot more complicated than that. Hopefully that beginning thing I just said isn't complicated. But trust me, these can be scary. They're definitely hard. I was scared to do these when I was first learning how to code. They're definitely challenging, but do them, write about them. If you can't solve one, bookmark it. Come back to it later. I've done videos where I'm like, hey, this is this code challenge that I tried to do a month or two ago. I couldn't do it. I felt like I was close, but I've already spent 2 hours trying to figure out the problem. And I'm gonna do it now, and 10 minutes. Whole thing done, I figured it out, it's easy, I have to be factored. So there's several reasons to do this, other than putting some type of content out. It makes you a better developer. It can show your growth. You can tell, like I said, you can say, hey, I did this video and I couldn't do it, took 2 hours, didn't finish it. Now you finished it in 10 minutes, and you're like, that 2 months, you see the growth that I've had and how much I've learned. And that can be really encouraging to other people. It's definitely encouraging to yourself. And now you have maybe another video or blog you can write. You've done a blog about how you overcame this challenge, and people are like, hey, can you write a blog about overcoming imposter syndrome? Can you write a blog about this, whatever it is that people might come up with? And they're like, yeah, sure, you know, I have another piece of content that I can have, and I can help another person. And somebody that's looking to hire you can say, oh, wow, this person wrote a, you know, this blog post, they're learning pretty fast. That challenge can be really challenging. And now I've just seen them do another blog post on imposter syndrome and overcoming it. I should hire them. Like, they're strong-minded, they're strong-willed. They'll figure things out. They won't fumble. This is definitely somebody you want on our team. Visiting the whole stuff. Read a lot of articles and blogs yourself. Watch a lot of videos. You can definitely take somebody else's influence and to what you're doing as well. You can just find things you're missing. You might watch a YouTube video of another developer, like, dang, they do tell people to like their videos so they can get more people to be able to see it. Or they do, this nice intro. I didn't even think to do an intro. I think I should do an intro. Or maybe they, you see somebody got a blog post and you feel out that they're writing blog posts on multiple sites. And you're like, yeah, I should share my stuff like that. So you'll find something. And if anything, you're learning. I read a lot of books, so books also help me kind of relax. Like, over the summer, I read a lot of books. And I read a book on, I read a lot of books. I put the Pragmatic Programmer in parentheses here. That's a really good book for programmers, I believe. So also put me onto that. And a lot of coworkers said that it's a really good book. So I went and checked it out. It's great. It gives you a lot of insight on how to think as a developer and how to write your code better. And it's a really good book. It's not super technical either. So you're not like literally reading code or anything. You're just reading about being a developer and bettering yourself as a developer. And I haven't took the steps to go to therapy. I definitely plan on it. And I think a lot of people should, especially being a developer is hard, being a human is hard. It'll definitely help you kind of relax, clear your mind, figure things out, work things out so that you can become a better developer, make better content, get more apps. And questions?
Yeah, so in terms of, marketing yourself online, did you make it obvious you were in the DC area or kind of that regards?
You said that, tell everybody what's in DC area?
Like, did you make it like obvious for
maybe? Yeah, so definitely. It's in my Twitter bio. You can see that I'm in the DC area. I'm also talked about it freely and openly. Also, you should definitely tweet that you're looking for a job and let them know what you're open to. So you can write a tweet that says, introduce yourself, say you're in the DC area, you're looking for a job, use your talents, and just kind of pin that at the top of your profile. And people might see a tweet you put out and be like, oh, that's pretty cool. And they might look at your profile and look and be like, oh, you're looking for a job. Okay, cool, I'll keep that in mind. Or, they might just send a DM and say, hey, my job's hiring. Or let's talk, let's put something in the calendar. And they saw it because you tweeted it. And you let them know, you're in a DC area. Also, if you're looking to work remote, you can say that as well. If you're looking to work remote.
What advice would you give to someone this is over, but being really introvert and a lot of the processes you're going through to establish yourself, put yourself out there, they don't necessarily, I want to say, have the capacity, but that's not their first go-to.
Yeah, sure. So I'm definitely an introvert. I don't know why I'm standing up here in front of you all, but I'm definitely an introvert. And for me, it was that whole overcoming my fear thing and just saying, this is really what I want to do. And I want this job, and I have a family support, and just it's either this or it could just get bad, right? So for me, I just kind of just jumped out there and was like, everything's right. What am I seeing? So just go for it. Also, I think it also helps that you're online and you're kind of anonymous. and maybe you just want to kind of dip your toe in the water and just kind of create a page where nobody knows you, and maybe just write under an alias, make videos without your like Facebook screen and just kind of screencast and don't let people know it's you. That's also, I would think, a good way to kind of ease into it without having to jump all the way in. And that's kind of a great thing about the internet is that it's anonymous.
How often did you publish videos and like how much work did it take? Did you stay at like
10? Yeah, so I said I was going to do 3 to 5 videos a week. And at first, that's what I was doing. I think I even got like a